Welcome back, kids, and hope you little ones enjoyed your time with Teacher Tina and Teacher Kim.
Yes.
Teacher Rainio, mm-hmm. I'd like for us now to, why don't you go ahead and remind them also of another exciting activity that we have every Sunday on our Facebook page.
Right. So every Sunday, as we've heard last week on our last episode, we have the Axtivity, which happens every Sunday. So Ax is our encouraging missions club in Sunday school. And every Sunday, they're going to be sharing with us stories, crafts, and other helpful activities, which you can do during this enhanced community quarantine.
Yes.
So this way, we're also learning new things about God, and we're also learning how we can help other people and be of encouragement, especially in this difficult time right now.
That's true. And also, it's important to know that this is also a way of how we can reach our oikos.
Yes.
I'm sure you're going to be asking in our kids.
What is oikos?
What is oikos, teacher? Oikos are people that the Lord wants us to reach out to. Well, if we start thinking about them, start praying for them. Right, Shelly? There's Shelly. And these people could be our relatives, our friends, classmates, and many more that the Lord would want us to reach out to. So we are actually training you as early as now to be, you know, prayerful and thinking of your oikos, and encouraging also mom and dad to do the same, because right now in the quarantine that we're experiencing, it's just the right time to really, you know, reach out to people that we want to encourage and give that hope, because many of them don't have that hope.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right. That's right. Mm-hmm. So once again, let us be of help and encouragement to one another. Now, let's get ready to worship our God together. Mm-hmm. We prepared two wonderful songs, as always, and we're going to be joined by our fellow Kid Lifers, Joy, Grace, and Hope.
Okay, kids, in thankful, we pump our hands into the air like this.
And then, in grateful, we pump our hands into the right and left.
And I want to be goes like this.
Let's worship together!
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love Him. I just want to lift my heart in prayer.
About the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love Him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done.
If
heart that holds on. A glorious light beyond all compare. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know you are here on earth. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, he'll never let go. Through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, he'll never let go. From every high and every low. Oh no, he'll never let go. Lord, you never let go of me. Your silence is a light that is coming for the heart that holds on. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you. Still I will praise you.
Amen. Praise God. We're so thankful at how God takes care of all our needs, you know, in the songs that we just sang about being thankful. And now we are also so excited because to prepare us for our lesson today, we have with us a very sweet little girl, and actually she's growing fast too. Her name is Shana Maktibay. So let's welcome her for the scripture reading.
Hello, KidLifers! I am Shana Gil Maktibay. Let us open our Bibles to Psalm 23. I will be reading from the English Standard Version, or ESV. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us continue to take God at His word.
Thank you so much, Shana, for helping us today with our scripture reading. Indeed, that's a beautiful passage,
that's
Psalm 23.
Right, Psalm 23.
And that's what we're going to be discussing today. So let's prepare for our Bible discussion. Get your Bibles ready, hardbound or soft copy. You can also get your coloring markers. And don't forget your journal, because we need to take insights and we should jot down our learnings so that we can learn more and appreciate what we're going to study. And let's also look at the markings that we will be learning for today. So let's open Psalm 23. This is how it's going to look like. Bam! So the words that we're going to mark are Lord. Mm-hmm. Okay, anything pertaining to the Lord, to the triangle. Okay, and then there's a me, right? Or there's another character there, so that's David. Okay, mm-hmm. The Lord is my, so my refers to David. So we're gonna mark it with a green box. Okay, we're going to add to our markings for today. The letter R is for righteousness. So draw a letter R over righteousness. That's mm-hmm. a yellow R. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now also for all geographical locations such as path, stream, okay, mm-hmm. and hills mm-hmm. or valley, you put double underline in green.
That's
and
right.
then for time, always put a clock, a multicolored mm-hmm. clock, as you always do. Okay? So that's how it's going to look like. So work on your markings first.
And we'll be back in a while.